regreso aquí en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota y estamos hoy con una edición especial hablando con Lindsay Brooks, el editor senior, the automotive engineer, and we're switching back to English because to continue this show about electric cars, hybrid cars. And as I was saying, we're talking with Lindsay Brooks, senior editor of Automotive Engineer. Lindsay, so we are talking about all the cars that are now in the market, but one in particular is getting like a lot of great reviews. Car of the year, car of the future, the best thing ever thing came out of the U.S. What is the Tesla Drive? I haven't had the opportunity to drive it. I know you already did recently, right?
Yeah, last Friday I was in San Francisco area for a whole bunch of new electric car introductions. The Ford C-Max Energy, which is their new plug-in hybrid C-Max, early in the week. And then GM, I drove the new Spark EV, which is their new A-Class urban commuter car, battery electric, in the middle of the week. Then I stayed out an extra day to visit Tesla Motors. And Tesla Motors is the company that was founded by the guy who started PayPal. His name's Elon Musk, and this guy also owns SpaceX, with NASA going out of the launch business, SpaceX is the company that gets rockets up to the space station. So this guy is an innovator, an entrepreneur, and being a Silicon Valley guy, he thought, you know, we've got to do something about emissions and the use of oil. Electric cars are the future. So he plowed his own money. This guy's a multi-billionaire, plowed his own money into starting a company called Tesla, which is named after Nikolai Tesla, who was one of the great inventors of electric motors and electric technology back in the 1800s. And so I visited their engineering headquarters, which is in Palo Alto, right in the middle of Silicon Valley, and then drove in a Model S over to the factory in Fremont, and then drove back from the factory back to Palo Alto. So I spent half of a day driving the new Model S, and I can tell you, Javier, this car is really an eye-opener. It is an excellent car, and particularly when you think that Tesla had only built their little Roadster before this, which was basically a Lotus Elise with a battery pack in it. I mean, a little more than that, but this Model S was a clean sheet from the ground up development, a all-electric, full-size, luxury performance sedan that I believe is the electric equivalent of, say, a BMW 7 Series. This car really blew me away.
That's amazing. So you were mentioning before that Tesla started developing the cars, the electric cars, with the Roadster, and that was like about 5-6 years ago, and
that's correct.
They got pretty good reviews, but this one is getting like Motor Trend Car of the Year, the Car of the Future. I mean, like, award after award. I mean, it's pretty amazing. And as you were saying, are they getting ahead in the game like Toyota did with the Prius with the battery pack, or what's that? It's making it so different and much better than anything that is out there now.
Well, they set out to make not only a good electric car, which you and I know that there are cars that, okay, so you don't have to, you can plug it in, it doesn't have any emissions, it's got a battery, but these early electric cars have never really been measured headlight to headlight against the best combustion cars, and I think that's what Tesla set out to do. They hired a chief engineer from Lotus in England who developed the body, all aluminum body, very very advanced, stiff, very high-tech body of this car, ultra lightweight. They hired some of the best engineers from the automakers. They headhunted people from Toyota, from GM, etc. They also hired some smart young guys and ladies from Silicon Valley, you know, people that were out of Stanford University who had never worked at a car company. And they said, you know, what are the downsides of electric vehicles? Well, they're not as fun to drive as a combustion engine car. They're not as refined as a combustion engine car. They don't go as far as a combustion engine car. They set out to beat all of those different metrics with the car. So they developed a great handling body with dynamics that are as good as anything from Europe. They developed a battery pack. Actually, the Model S is available with three different battery packs, and this is a really interesting way to approach electric cars that I think other companies are going to use as well. The base model of the car is about $58,000, and it comes with a 40-kilowatt-hour battery pack that gives you about 160 miles range. Then there's a mid-range model that comes with a 60-kilowatt-hour battery pack. It has about 230 miles range.
That's amazing.
The car I drove is the top line. That's called the Signature Model S, and it comes with an 85-kilowatt-hour battery pack. And it gives between 250 and 300 miles of range per charge. Now, 300 miles is typical range for a combustion engine car. You know,
your tank of gas, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, your gas tank will take you about 300 miles. So that's what you got to do. And Javier, that is the key to getting EVs more mainstream in the future. Is number one, we're all used to standing at the gas pump and taking no more than 5 minutes to fill up a 15 to 20 gallon tank. Nobody is going to put up with more time than that to charge a car. So you got to do that. So the car charges quickly because they offer a quick charger with the car. It's got 300 miles of range per charge. And the great thing for enthusiasts like you, I know you like to drive performance cars, the Signature model, we'll do 0 to 60 in just about 4 seconds.
Yeah, that's what I was reading here, 4.4
seconds. And it's
got
a top speed of over 125 miles per hour. Now, the Signature model with that big battery pack, with all the bells and whistles, it lists between $95,000 and $105,000, depending on the options. Now, so when I'm a rich guy and I'm the host of Auto 0 to 60,
I think that'll be
my car. But you know, they're building 1,000 of these Signature models first. They're ramping up production to about 20,000 per year, which in the scheme of things compared to GM or Toyota is a small number. But in terms of electric cars at this performance level, this is really good.
Yeah,
now, Tesla has a long-term strategy to do the Model X after this, which will be a lower-priced car, and then they've got what they call the Generation 3 car, which will be even higher volume. So right now, their plant in Fremont, California, which is the old GM Toyota plant where they used to build Pontiac Vibes there, is only using part of this plant. And it's pretty much a low, very slow-speed assembly line, a lot of hand production operations. Eventually, when they do the Model X and the Generation 3 car, they're going to fill this plan out. And so the plan is for them to be a full-scale manufacturer over the next 10 years or so.
Yeah.
But why not start? Their strategy, I think, was good. Why not start with a top-line, no-excuses, high-performance electric car that will get them a lot of press worldwide, get them
good
a lot
press.
Of attention.
Yeah.
And then kind of work their way down. It's going to be tough, I think, for Tesla, though, Javier, once they get into higher volume, to compete with the Toyotas and GMs of the world.
Well, yeah, but
that's going to be a real challenge for those guys.
No, absolutely. But this is a car, as you were saying, that can be compared to a BMW 5 or 7 Series even. And the lower model starts under 50,000. So with this amazing technology that they have developed, I mean, it's pretty affordable. It's got to the point where people are going to say, okay, this is a great car with great technology, and it's not that so expensive. I mean, they will start considering that instead of other models in the similar category, like mid-size sedans.
Well, you're going to see, I think, a little bit of a battle brewing here because, yeah, the lowest priced Tesla, the base model, is about 58 grand, okay? So a little less than 60, let's say it's a $60,000 car.
What I said, the 49, that was included with the 7,000 federal tax credit, so that's what the difference, okay.
Oh, that's right, and your readers, your listeners probably know that the U.S. government gives a $7,500 tax break on electric cars,
yeah.
And then the state of California gives another $2,500. So that's 10 grand off the top if you live in California.
Oh, I see. That price comes up under 50, but it's really 60, the real price.
Really 60, but the interesting part is that all the other makers are starting with kind of low-priced electric cars, and they're working their way up. What Tesla's doing is starting with a 7 Series competitor, and then they're going to work their way down. So at some point, little Tesla is going to be battling it out with the big guys, I think, in terms of electrified vehicles. And it's going to be interesting to see really see how that works. But this Model S, you know, it's one thing to get performance, it's one thing to get battery range, but to create a car, what they call, what engineers call systems integration, was making the whole thing work really well. So you're not just saying, well, it's got good battery power, but these other things don't work so well. They use all their hardware in the car comes from Mercedes, which they have a partnership with. So all the switchgear, the turn signal switch, the lighting, all the switches are top-notch. The door hinges, the seals of the doors, the way they close, are all kind of Mercedes quality.
Yeah, so they're part of the car.
Across the line, this car is just great. And I got to tell you, for your listeners, they got to go to an auto show and see this 17-inch, basically a 17-inch iPad built into the center stack of the car.
That's amazing.
This thing does everything. It's got the best backup camera in the business. You can adjust the amount of regenerative braking in this car to have either a very aggressive feel or a very softer feel. You can adjust the suspension in this car all through this. It's like almost having a TV instrument panel, you know?
Excellent.
And this thing, and I'm sure, Javier, when you order your Model S and you take orders, you'll enjoy this thing too. But this feature just engaged me, you know?
Leslie, we're finishing the third segment. We're talking to Leslie Brook, editor-in-chief of Automotive Engineer. And we'll be back with the last segment of this electric special cars, about talking about the future of the electric car. No se vayan, ya regresamos aquí en Auto 060, show especial de autos eléctricos.